My dear friends, as St. James says, every good gift that you and I receive in the world comes from God, our Father. For our spiritual journey, God has given us a beautiful gift, the days of Lent, 40 days. In the Bible, 40 days, the number 40 is so holy and it symbolizes many things. We read in the book of 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 20. In the great house of God, there are varieties of vessels. Some are made of gold, some are by silver, some may be made by wood, and even some are made by mud. But each vessel God prepares for a purpose. And through each vessel, He brings glory and honor to Himself. When those vessels, when they fulfill the Master's purpose, they bring glory and honor. Yes, that's what we read in the book of Romans chapter 9, verse 17. I have created you, that through you, your God will be glorified. That's what we read in Romans chapter 9, verse 23. Though we are weak and sinful beings, God shows His mercy that we may bring forth God's glory on this earth. My dear friends, when Noah was called by God, Noah met the Lord and he witnessed the glory of God. For 40 days and nights, the rain was pouring. Yes, these 40 days are the days of grace God gives to you and me and to this sinful, broken world to see the glory and power of God. Having experienced the glory and mercy and power of God, we establish that mercy in this broken world and build up God's kingdom. But we read in the life of Noah, after 40 days of experiencing the power of God, he came out and he began to thank God, praise God, worship God. 40 days he was experiencing the glory and power of God pouring out rain from heaven. And he thanked God 40 days. So in Lenten's experience, the 40 days, the first part of it is, we experience the glory and power of God. God is calling each one of us to share in His glory, to share in His power. But the man who walked 40 days, Noah, who saw the glory of God for 40 days, when he came out, he planted the vineyard, he made the wine, he drank, and he became a drunkard. And still worse, when he was lying in his nakedness, his youngest son Ham saw him and sinned with him. The father got up and he cursed Ham and his son Canaan. My dear friends, this beautiful season of Lent is, on the one hand, we see the glory and mercy of God towards man. We see the power of God in our lives. On the other hand, with mere devotion and praising and thanking God, our life doesn't end. With what God has done to us, with what God's mercy has shown to us, we become people of God. We begin to experience God by offering ourselves. We recognize our own sinfulness. We recognize the sinfulness and brokenness of our people in the world. These 40 days, on the one hand, we see the glory and power of God that begins to operate in us. On the other hand, these 40 days makes us like God, to be merciful. And we become the channels of God's power to this broken world. Yes, Noah, he received 40 days of glory. He saw the glory of God in 40 days, but he did not transform himself. And rather, he became a cause to curse his own son and the generation. Jesus said in John's Gospel, chapter 15, verse 5 and 7, "As I am with you, if anyone is with me, they will bear fruit. If you remain in me and my words remain in you, you will bear much fruit." Yes, in this season of Lent, we see Jesus of Nazareth in these 40 days, how he has come, and through his death and resurrection, what is the love he has shown for us. He suffered for us. He has carried away our sickness, our sinfulness, and all our sadness, and brought us salvation. So in these 40 days, we walk with Jesus as he carried the cross and brought us salvation. At the same time, in these 40 days, we too become broken vessels like our Master. We too surrender our lives for God and for our brothers and sisters and our neighbors. And we become a broken vessel to bring God's power to this world. Jesus came into the world to save you and me. It's not the good news. The good news is Jesus has come to save the mankind. And when we join with Christ and crucify ourselves, and we bring God's glory and power to this broken world, you and I become the good news of Jesus Christ to this world. In these 40 days, God wants us to have that great life. On the one hand, we see the glory of God. On the other side, we manifest that glory, that mercy, that love to the world. We read in the book of Exodus, chapter 34. Yes, here we find another great servant of God, Moses. God called him for 40 days, and he went up, and he was with God. And God took the stones from heaven, and he wrote the Ten Commandments. The face of Moses was blazing like a fire. He received, being with God, he received. God was with him. And when Moses received those 10 commandments, the Lord said, "My son, go down. Your people whom you brought, they have sinned against me, and they have made a golden calf, and they are worshipping." The man who received the wood, the stone of 10 commandments from God, the stones made of heaven, when he saw the people, their sin, he broke that stones from heaven. Yes, God was with Moses. God wrote 40 days and spoke to Moses. But Moses did not become a transferred man. So he broke what God had given to him. So if these 40 days, if we only are going to spend in devotion and in fasting, in praying, in giving alms for the people, and if that doesn't transform us to make like Christ, make us like Christ, and bring His salvation today to the world through you and me, the Lent doesn't fulfill its purpose. Now God called once again Moses back and said, "My son, what I made of gold, what I made of heaven, the stone you broke and destroyed it. Now you bring the stone from this earth and I will write and give it to you." Yes, we break whatever God has given to us. Then God calls us once again from this earth to come to Him, to give our earthly struggle, to give our earthly sin to Him, to give our earthly weakness to God, that He can transform us. So in these 40 days, we not only receive the grace and glory from heaven, but also we give our brokenness, our disturbances, our weaknesses, and allow God to transform us and make us people of mercy, people of love. We cry in these 40 days, "Lord, make me a merciful person. Lord, make me like you. Lord, make me a person of divine love and compassion." Yes. Now the Lord tells Moses, "My son, your people have sinned against you, and I will raise you up, and through your generation, once again I will build up a new world." Moses says, "No, Lord, have mercy on your people. If you don't forgive my people, please take away my name from the book of life." Now Moses became not only a person who met the Lord in 40 days, but a man who becomes like the Master, a merciful man, a man who pleading for his people, a man who is becoming an embodiment of God's divine love on this earth. Yes, the meaning of Lent is God is calling us for the 40 days as He called Noah, as He called Moses, to receive His glory and to become like Christ and bring God's mercy, God's love, and God's compassion to this broken world, God's power to this powerless world. Yes, but the people of Israel, they, with the grace and mercy of God, they got deliverance from Egypt, but they did not walk with God who walked with them. So their lives were a broken lives. Many people through their lives to become drunkards, and in the desert they went and sinned with the prostitutes. Oh, many of them died, and very few people moved ahead in life. My dear friends, once again the Lord says, when the people of Israel did not walk with God, they have to walk for 40, not 40 days, 40 years. Yes, we may have many talents, we may be God's servants, we may be knowing all that. If we don't walk with God, God walks with us. But when we walk with God, we become His vessels. And these 40 days, God is calling us to know Him, to be with Him, and to experience His power on the one hand. On the other hand, become like God and offering ourselves to God and bring God's glory and power to this broken world. Yes. Now we read another great servant whose name is Elijah. Elijah was a mighty man. He saw miracles and wonders. When he prayed, in 1 Kings chapter 18, we read, God brought fire from heaven. When he prayed, after 3.5 years, the rain came. Yes, God helped him to experience the power of God. He was a man of fasting. He was a man of praying. Yes, in these 40 days, we become men and women of prayer and receive something of heaven on this earth. Don't get satisfied with what you have received from the earth. Without receiving the power of heaven, you can't handle your life on this earth. Too many are the brokenness. Too many are the temptations. Too many are the attacks of the enemy. You need the heavenly power. So these 40 days you spend like Elijah, hungering for him, thirsting for him, receive the power and show to this broken world, including India, the power and glory of God. If you and I, through our fasting and praying, if we don't bring and show the glory and power of God, how can the nations will know the Lord? And God is giving you and me these 40 days of grace and glory to know Him, to love Him, and to invest our time with Him and possess His power and glory. On the other hand, we find Elijah, when the enemy attacked him through the lady called Jezebel, he ran away. In 18th chapter, he brought fire from heaven. In the 19th chapter, he runs away from God and says, "I want to die, Lord." Yes, these 40 days, not only that we receive the grace and the power and glory of God, the heaven to this earth, but also to become like God. Now God is coming, showing mercy to Elijah, bringing food from heaven and water from heaven and feeding him and telling him, "Get up, my son. Now you walk on the mountain. Now you walk into my presence. And with my presence, you can face this world." Rain came as Elijah was walking. Storm came, and even the earthquake came. But with the experience, "My God is with me. Even when I am in the desert, my God fed me." With that experience, Elijah walked 40 days. So these 40 days of grace God has given to you and me in the name of Lent is with the faith we move ahead. We cross over every struggle and pain of our life. We don't get stuck up with a storm, with the earthquake, with a heavy wind that comes in our way. Yes, when he moved with the faith and walked for 40 days, he was filled with the Holy Spirit. And he became a humble man and came back and ordained the priests, the kings, the king of Samaria, the king of Israel, and a great prophet called Elisha. Yes, these 40 days of grace, God is calling you and me to possess with what the heaven gives to us, the power and glory of God, through our fasting and prayer. And we train our body and make our body to receive the glory of God. Yes, on the other hand, we also train our hearts to become a man, a woman of compassion, mercy, and God's presence to this broken world. May God bless you with this beautiful season and make you like Himself. My dear friends, in this season of Lent, we also move with Jesus, who, filled with the Holy Spirit, He fasted for 40 days and nights and manifested and showed Satan, "The Holy Spirit, the power I have, is greater than your power." With the power of the Holy Spirit, He defeated Satan. On the other hand, 40 days, He also trained and broke His body to fulfill the will of the Father. May this season of Lent move with Jesus. May Jesus be our way, the truth and the life, to possess the power of the Holy Spirit and to offer our body as a living sacrifice. Let's pray. God, Heavenly Father, we praise you and thank you for these 40 days of grace you are giving to us to walk with you, to be with you, to be with the one who has come to be with us. Yes, Lord, you move with those who move with you. You don't move with those who are sitting down. These 40 days you have given to us, that we, with our fasting and praying and almsgiving, we possess your own Holy Spirit. We possess your power. We possess the power of heaven and bless this earth. On the other hand, Lord, help us in these 40 days to humble ourselves and to transform our weakness, our brokenness, our sinfulness, and to become holy and to become like you, to build this world with your compassion, with your mercy, with your power, and with your spirit. Bless all those who are listening to the word of God. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.